Did you know that both red and black wires in AC circuits are hot, but in DC circuits, they are positive and negative? That's confusing, I know, but clearing up the confusion of wire colors is exactly what I'm going to teach you here in lesson number 3 of this Wire Basics playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, before we get started, I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and some prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comment below. So be sure to scroll down and check it out. USA wire colors versus everywhere else. In this video, we're only going to be talking about wire colors commonly found in the United States of America. Now, after a brief look, it appears that many countries have different wire colors. So I'm just going to explain what is common in my area, and hopefully it'll give you a good jumping off point for determining wire colors in yours. And if you already have your head wrapped around what wire colors are common in your area, let me know down in the comments what country you're from and any specific wire colors that are used there. Why are wires different colors? Wires are different colors so that, at a glance, a trained person can tell what flavor of electricity is flowing through the wire and more easily identify where the wire might be going and what it may be powering. This is why here in the United States, we have a highly standardized system across all realms that makes wire colors so simple that they just make sense, right?
It's worse. It's so much worse.
What are the common AC circuit wire colors? Fortunately, wire colors in AC circuits actually are standardized and they are easy to identify. In standard Romex for stationary applications here, we've got black for hot, white for neutral, and bare copper with no insulation for ground. Now, if this were a 120-240 split phase application where we may have two hot power wires, there would be a fourth wire in the sheath that is going to be hot leg 2, and it's always going to be red. Now, if we're using stranded triplex or four conductor wire like we talked about back in lesson 3.2 of this academy, the ground wire would be coated in green insulation, like so, green for ground. So to recap, if you have an AC circuit, black is hot line 1, red is hot line 2, white is neutral, and green is ground, or it could be bare copper. What are the common DC circuit wiring colors? Now let's get into the dumpster fire that is DC wire colors. In DC circuits, most commonly, red is positive and black is negative. In all of the Explorist Life wiring diagrams and wiring kits, we use red for positive and black for negative. The same thing in all of Victron's wiring diagrams. If you go look under the hood of your vehicle, you've likely got a red wire connected to the positive battery terminal and a black wire connected to the negative battery terminal. Easy enough, right? Well, what if you look into an area of your camper and there's two black wires and you don't know if it's an AC hot wire or a DC negative wire? Well, since both of those wires are black, you may not have any way to tell which is which outside of tracing the wire back to its source or over to the load. This is why the American Boat and Yacht Council has released a standard for the colors of DC wires that says that positives should be red and negatives should be either black or yellow, which aims to fix this problem. Now, unfortunately, the Wild West RV industry has decided that instead of red and black, there's a lot of RV manufacturers that use white and black instead. Black for positive and white for negative. Even worse, some van upfitters have gone to branded colors like orange or lime green or polka dots or stripes or whatever they want in their electrical systems for aesthetic purposes. Personally, I'd rather my electrical systems be clear and safe over aesthetically pleasing, but that's just me. Is there a wire color cheat sheet? In an attempt to summarize all of this and keep our installations as spark-free as we can, Explorist Life systems and diagrams, Victron diagrams, and most other sources have positive as red and negative as black. Boats and yachts typically have positive as red, negative as black, or yellow. Some RV manufacturers have positive as black and negative as white. And everybody is mostly on the same page with AC circuits with black as hot line 1, red as hotline 2, white as neutral, and green or bare copper as ground. So if you see a black wire, just know it could be an AC hot, a DC positive, or a DC negative.
Good luck.
Now, as far as all the other colors of wires or striped wires or anything like that around a DC system, those are usually for like specific loads or are signal wires, and there's really no way to like summarize those. Although the American Boat and Yacht Council has made a good effort to do so in Table 12 of Standard E11. Now, I know this topic is a bit confusing, but I hope this video provided at least some clarity into wire colors in a mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system. Now, it is worth mentioning that the system kits and diagrams we sell in our store over at shop.explorist.life have all of the proper wire colors included or figured out for you, and we provide free support for customers. And if the thought of messing up wire colors scares you away from your next electrical project, we now offer installation services as well, and I'll put a link to our store and our installation services below. Now, we're going to be referring to wire colors throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this video for future reference and come back to it for a refresher if you need it. In the next lesson, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about understanding how much power a wire can handle, so click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.